Hey everybody, happy holidays and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to the next episode of The 100. This is season 7, episode 15 of the final season titled The Dying of the Light. Also, this is going to be a reaction to the final episode. You're getting this 2-in-1 on Patreon and on YouTube. We'll be getting this 2-in-1, so this will be a little extra long video of highlights on YouTube. Of course, if you guys want to skip the YouTube highlights, hop on over to Patreon, but of course, this is for the final episode also. We'll do like a little mini introduction after we watch episode 15, before we move on to the finale. I'm going to try to keep this kind of like a, treat it like a little movie. So two episodes, 42 minutes apiece, you know, 80 plus minutes. So it's kind of like a movie, hour and a half, more or less. This is the final two episodes, guys. I can't believe we're here. It's been a while since I started the show, and I do want to thank you guys for sticking along with me. It has been one hell of a ride, and I think I've mentioned it before that the show has gotten to a place where it almost feels like a completely different show as opposed to what we've seen in the past. Like, compare one of the latest episodes of The 100 to episode 1, the pilot episode, you know what I mean? And I'm just like, it's like apples and oranges. It's like completely different. The tone is different. Characters have changed. You know, everybody's like, they've gone through shit. And that's what I kind of appreciate about the show. And I'll be honest, it does suck that it has the CW stench to it, but I feel like it's overcome that. I feel like I almost feel a little shitty that I wasn't watching this like live with everybody else, because when I first, you know, probably saw it advertised, I'm like, whatever. It's just a teeny bopper show. Fast forward to now, and I'm just like, yeah, it did start out that way, but it evolved into something so much more. I mean, the lore itself is kind of the biggest selling point to it, all the backstory and stuff. It's just such a shame we didn't get a prequel series, or we didn't get any sort of like video game or comic book or animated series or just some sort of continuation of the story. I mean, I don't know how the story's going to end, but I already know that I'm going to have a lot to say about it. You know, there's going to be more good than bad, of course. You've already heard the bad of that I've, you know, witnessed throughout the show. And that's mostly from the earlier seasons. Everything now, I've been like such a fan of. Like, season 6 has been really strong. That was probably like my favorite season up from, in terms of comparison that one into this one. We'll see how this one ends, but 6 was really strong, and I really enjoyed Josephine and all that, all the sci-fi aspects. Like, when we got away from just, you know, battling for the Earth, I like that we kind of just took it one step further. Body swapping, all that good stuff. I mean, the show just evolved to a point where it's almost unrecognizable. And I'm just thinking, like, down the line, if they were to ever reboot the show, how would they do it? Should they do it, you know, through the eyes of a grounder? Maybe we'll go through the eyes of Indra and Gaia, and, you know, we'll learn about the grounder culture, and then we'll have it portrayed that the people, the Sky Crew, are coming down, and they're the bad guys. They're the rowdy teenagers that are here to fuck shit up. They're the bad guys, you know what I mean? So it's like, if they were to, there's so many things that this show has done and built that's like, wow, thumbs up to everybody involved. But obviously, it does have the CW stink to it, at least in the earlier seasons. But that being said, I'm ready to hop into this and see where the story just, how it all ends. Because the last episode ended with, what, Shane Hayda, he, like, threw a grenade or something through the portal, and it kind of, like, fucked shit up. I believe it ended with, like, John and Amori. Like, it appeared like they were being crushed by rubble, but I believe it was the stone that was uncovered, because they were looking for the stone. So, we'll see what happens with that. Xavier is dead, right? No, not Xavier. Why'd I call him that? Gabriel. No, it is Xavier, right? That's his real name. Gabriel was the one with Josephine. Xavier's dead. We'll see what happens going forward. I mean, they are moving forward with the Jordan and Hope romance, which is fine. You know, I'm totally okay with that. But yeah, we'll just hop in and see what happens going forward. Bellamy's dead. Clark got off easy with that one, if you ask me. But let's just hop in, have a good time, discuss it afterwards. But before I do want to remind you guys, Patreon for the full-length, uncut, unedited reactions, as well as early access to everything else you see here on the channel, as well as exclusive reactions. So if any of that interests you, hop on over to Patreon. Of course, if you can't support me over there, you can always support me right here on YouTube. All you gotta do is like, comment, share, subscribe to the channel. Now let's stop talking. Hop in, have a good time, discuss it afterwards. All right, guys. Here we go for one final time.
Shadehead got away. He stabbed himself in the gut.
Oh, didn't Maddie, like, stab herself somehow? And she, like, zapped away somewhere? But stabbing herself, though? Damn. They threw a bomb. Yeah. I think they uncovered the stone. I don't think... they're dead. Oh, that would be some shit if she got, like, hurt.
Amore, answer me!
Murphy! Murphy, are you okay?
Where's Amore?
Where was she? She was right in front of me. She was right there.
You're probably concussed.
No, I'm not.
Too many. We need to find
if she was with you, she won't be far. We'll work a grid.
A grid? She's, like, in front of us. What the fuck? Raven, are you just saying words? Work a grid? She's, like, right here. What the fuck?
Thank God. I thought you...
Ah! No.
It's just a scratch.
Aw, man. She better not die that way.
We can still get to Maddie.
Oh. Yeah, how does that work?
We have to think this through.
Guy's right. Only the second pill's for me.
We're gonna
leave an inside man.
Good. Let's do it.
What?
Why isn't this working?
Maybe somebody has to be waiting in Bardo to pull you through.
Who? Who's still over there? Like somehow get a message to Maddie or something? I don't know.
Clark. We have to get to Maddie. Gattigan could be digging into her brain right now.
I mean, how does time work there? I mean, how long has it been? Does time move at the same time as on Earth here?
Maddie. My name is Levin.
No, right?
So glad you've chosen to join us.
Like, is Clark gonna get to Maddie and she's gonna be like old or some shit? Or dead because she's like, Clark took too long? That would be some shit.
Don't worry, it won't hurt. Pain interferes with the readings.
Great.
It's not too bad.
Good. Just lay your head back and get comfortable.
Remember when Echo, like, killed that guy by stabbing him with that needle? Where's Bellamy? Ah! It'd be cool if there was still blood on it. Like, what's that?
I'm gonna start by going through a baseline scenario. Imagine you're in an endless desert with a vast purple sky. A hand reaches out for your own. Whose is it?
Clark.
Neural link engaged.
Well done, Maddie. I know you're afraid, but if your mind contains the final code, it'll all be worth it.
Okay.
Gabriel said Jordan studied the texts. You think it's a war because you want a war.
Oh yeah, wasn't it, deciphered differently?
I'm sorry, but I find it unlikely that a boy who studied the text once knows better than those of us who've spent generations with
them. Yeah, but he's Monty's son, and he has plot armor, okay?
After all, what is war but a test of might and will?
Okay,
so,
fair enough.
Maddie, I don't want a war. I don't want to send my children to die. I welcome that test.
Yeah, but we don't want him to take the test, right? Like, that's the whole thing?
We received a signal from Earth. Two nanotags have been activated.
Clark and Octavia.
These people are no doubt worried about her. For now, leave them there. They'll thank us after we've transcended, taking
Okay.
We're ready to begin. You doing okay, Maddie?
Yes.
I want to show you something. Think back to this image.
What else do you remember about her?
That's not Lexa, is it?
I don't know.
It's probably obvious, and I'm just an idiot.
Don't worry, Maddie. We'll figure this out together.
I'm not doing this for you. I'm doing this to save my friends. My family.
You're very brave.
Sir, it's strange. This particular memory is not registering in any of the areas that memories are usually stored.
She drew things that she couldn't have seen.
The flame. Same thing with the code. Are they gonna fucking lobotomize her?
They tell me you're the best.
I trust you.
For all mankind.
My inside man is sure taking his sweet time.
We get Maddie and kill their leader.
Yeah.
Gattigan won't change anything.
Faith doesn't just die. It gets carried forward. Gattigan's people are no different.
Fighting is not how we get there. War is a failure of everything.
What if the test is like something weird? Like you have to like kill yourself or something. Then that's how you transcend into the light.
I don't claim to fully understand it, but in my heart, I know there's a purpose to everything. I just wish I could have told Bellamy.
Bellamy's dead because he believed that crap, and I've heard enough.
Where are you going?
What the hell was Maddie thinking? She just left without even talking to me.
Well, yeah.
All I ever did was try to save people.
We're all the heroes of our own story, Clark. Remember that. You're the villain of someone else's story.
Is this how my mom felt?
Probably.
Every time. Because I feel like I can't get enough air. Did I do that to her?
You remember when you shocked her? That wasn't great either.
I didn't mean to.
And I'm sure your mother knew that.
And your mother shocked Raven. I mean, y'all are fucked up.
Maddie went to Bardo to save us. I'm proud of her for that.
Great.
I killed Bellamy to protect her from the disciples.
And she just walks in the door,
so
yeah.
She could turn herself in.
Yeah. Is there a way to get Bellamy back? No way. He just died like that, right? It's still kind of annoying to me.
I can't keep doing this. Not again. If I lose Maddie too.
What? You're gonna die?
I'll have nothing.
Nothing to live for?
Be nothing.
One head. Ah! Jesus!
The rebar can wait. She's losing too much blood. I don't think it severed the artery, but we need to cauterize the wound.
I just wish I had a proper anesthetic for you.
Not as much as she does.
Ruffy, put pressure on this.
You hated playing primers.
Yeah, but you loved it. That's enough for me.
Oh no! Is this our final conversation?
This is the first time I mattered.
You always matter to me.
Wow, and that's true too. Ever since what, season 3? 2? I don't remember.
Go.
You did so good, you just gotta hang on with us now, okay?
Hey! I heard screaming! Did you find Echo?
Raven's like...
This is all I could find. Maybe it will help.
I need to get to Sanctum.
What about Maddie? What about the rest of our crew?
We'll worry about them later.
Yeah, but the time difference. Oh man, now I'm getting nervous.
Just because you can't see something doesn't mean it's not there.
I think that was a line from like Small Soldiers or something. Small Soldiers was a great movie.
Is there an Asgata symbol on the floor?
Don't know, don't care.
Asgata?
X marks the spot.
That's not an X, though.
John, something's wrong.
What?
Hey, stay with us. Stay with us, all right?
Echo's Asgata. You should be worried about her, too.
I am. You are more important than any other person in this universe.
Murphy, I need to repack this.
But if we don't get her to Sanctum soon, she's not gonna make it.
No!
Okay. Oh, that's his daughter, Callie. Yeah, right. He wants his daughter, the code. Right.
You're doing so well.
I'm not ready. We're not ready. Not you.
Not you. What?
What's wrong?
I saw everything. Becca went to the other side. She said he's not ready.
Who's not ready?
I'm done helping you.
Becca and I had a disagreement.
Oh, right.
Now was our time.
Uh-huh.
Let's start again.
I said...
Well, this is gonna hurt.
Guards, you're hurting yourself.
Restrain her. Can't let her harm herself. Step aside this time, beloved. Take it easy.
Sir, we need to do this another way.
There is no other way. You're too close to this.
You find someone else. Oh, God damn it.
Stop this. For the good of the many, I have no choice but to continue.
Go float yourself.
The nanotech's from Earth. He wants those people brought over.
Now.
I thought he ordered us to ignore them.
Fine. I'll go tell the Shepherd that you refuse his order. He can come here himself.
Okay, go ahead.
Wait. Bringing them over. It'll take me a few minutes to relink to their tags.
I wish someone would call their bluff and be like, yeah, go ahead, I'll wait right here. And then what would they do? Like, oh, shit. What? Oh. The tags.
I don't want to be alone again.
Sometimes, to do the right thing, you have to take a risk. Your mom knew that too.
Can you not hold on to her? Okay, well, that... explains that. Hey. Oh.
You're not alone.
Good job, Jordan. Remember when you banged Priya like on day one of arriving on a new planet, despite not having any social cues or they just blabbed all their secrets to everybody? It's like, remember, Clark's the commander of death and kills everybody. Don't trust her. Pretty cool.
No.
What's the plan? Clark's not giving up. Yeah, so what? What? God damn it. Can you not just pull that shit out?
Come on, Jackson.
She looks horrible.
Don't talk like that. We are getting you out of here.
God, you're not making...
You're exhausted. I can take over.
I'm fine.
Raven.
Don't do it, Mori. Recovery is psychological. As much as it is medical. She thinks she's gonna die.
Copy that. Hey, don't get up.
I like how they can still crack a joke in dire situations.
Our time on the ring. You hated that. Me.
You loved it.
Even though we were trapped in a tin can. Those are still some of the best times of my life.
Wow, she's dying.
It's safe.
She's dying. They're not gonna make it in time.
You are getting through this. We're almost to the stone.
She's about to let go. Don't die without saying bye to John, though. No.
I want you to go to Bardo. What? Forget taking me to Sanctum.
Cadigan could already have the code to start the last war.
We can't let him doom all of humanity. Stop him.
Amori's giving herself up.
I'm not letting you die. We already lost Bellamy. If it's a choice between saving me and saving everyone, you choose everyone. Please.
God, what a hero.
John, he won't be able to. But you.
You're gonna lie to him? Oh, that's fucked up. Don't do that. He's gonna think they're going to Sanctum. He's gonna be so mad.
I'm done watching the people I love die. You're being stubborn.
That's the Raven way.
Yeah, it's gonna think.
Don't go out like this. Yeah, there you go.
And then I'm gonna save everyone else.
Is that it? Better be, come on.
It's the stone, Amori.
Oh no.
Amori. She's not breathing.
Oh my god. Come on.
I can keep her blood circulating, but we need to get back to Sanctum.
Work faster, come on.
Oh, this is stressing me out.
Sorry that took me so long.
Hate to interrupt, but we need to get to Maddie. Here's the deal. I'd love to kill you. But you're right.
I need you. Is there some way to kill Shade Hata and...
I'm not some petty distraction.
And Katagan all together?
King of Sanctum.
Okay, you're
maybe Shade Hata kills Katagan and rules Bardo or whatever.
You walk out of here,
he can be on his little bubble forever.
Distraction it is.
And maybe like deactivate the stone so he can't go anywhere and no one can come here. That would be like his ultimate prison. Rule these people!
Attention, sheep.
I'm here to kill your shepherd.
What level are these guys? Because they don't seem very impressed. So, I wonder what the power levels are like, because Shade Hata's like moving, mowing through these guys like nothing. That was a cool shot. But Echo couldn't take Orlando. And Echo's a badass. Don't break it though. I feel like he's gonna break it. Yeah, but what if the codes are on the other side of the damn sphere? Lucky as hell. Super lucky.
Thank you. We're not losing anyone else. Let's go.
We'll come back for Miller. Where is he? What happened to him? I almost forgot about him. He did something with the bomb, right?
He's not here. We knew that was a possibility. We'll deal with Shade Hata later.
You say that a lot, and he's always like a bigger problem when he shows back up.
Come on. Right now, all that matters is getting to Maddie.
Okay. Wow. Well, obviously this is a trap. Levitt, you should probably still pretend like you're not working with them.
Maddie, I'm here.
Just in case. There's cameras or something? Oh, shit. Wait. Is she breathing?
Something's wrong.
Check her.
She's breathing. Why isn't she okay. responding?
I'm accessing the history now.
Wow. Maddie looks dead. They did a really good job on her makeup.
Say something.
She catatonic? What happened to her?
Say something! Oh, my baby.
Damn, this is a good scene too. I would actually be sad if Maddie died.
Well, how is she?
There's still no activity.
Okay. Oh shit.
Neural activity is good, right?
She's conscious, but she can't move.
So she can hear us. Oh, that sucks. How do we reverse it?
Clark, she can hear you. Hey, baby. I'm here. I'm right here. Is it recoverable?
What?
Oh, don't lie, though.
No. The areas of her brain responsible for voluntary movement have been destroyed.
Oh my god, is she like this forever? So she's dead, basically. Maybe, like, put her in something, I don't know, put her in another body? Are they gonna do that? Oh my god. Poor Maddie, that sucks. She didn't deserve this.
I'll do it.
Do what? Are you gonna kill her?
I'm not letting you live with this.
Oh, no, no, no! Take her with you! Don't do this.
I love you so much.
They're really gonna do this! Don't! Oh, I'd be pissed! Are they really gonna do this? What? No, 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 no!
You'll gladly stay or not.
Oh, God!
No. He got the code.
Look.
And left her here?
We have to stop him. One man represents the entire human race.
It can't be him.
Yeah.
We can still stop him, but we have to go now.
God, he just used her and left her here like garbage. Oh, man. You have to kill this guy. You have to. Is there not...
You've wanted this your whole life.
Before you, I didn't have a life.
Whatever.
And I promise I will not let him live.
But is Maddie suffering like this? I'm not gonna lie. That was such a powerful moment. I don't know if I want them to fix Maddie. I feel like this would be a good ending. It would like motivate Clark to really, aww. Oh shit. Okay, guys, we're about to hop into the next episode. I just some quick thoughts. I'm not gonna lie. I like what we're doing, but I don't want us to kind of fix Maddie or save her some way, somehow. I like what we're doing. I like the setup. I like how we've set it up so that once Clark finally does kill Cadigan, that's what I'm assuming is gonna happen. She's gonna come back and say her final goodbyes to Maddie. I feel like that's going to be the final moment of the show, or some way, somehow. Maybe they'll both die together, or they lose somehow and they both just die together. But there has to be a better way to just put Maddie to rest than just shooting her, right? Like, they're legit just going to shoot her? Was that like a regular gun or something else? Because it looked like they were just about to shoot her in the heart. What I would have done is maybe found some way to like properly or safely or... like euthanize her some way, somehow, you know what I mean? I don't know, some sort of poison that will, like, I don't know, just not necessarily cause it. Well, she can't move anyway. She can't feel anything, but she knows she can hear things. Just such a horrible way for her to go out. Like, Cadigan, he got what he wanted from her, left her, discarded her. Like, just left her, like, behind, like, trash. It's, what a fucking monster. So, I don't know. I'm really just eager to hop into the next one. So, I'm about to do that right now. So, if you're watching this on Patreon, sorry for the brief intermission. I just had to, like, say a few things. So, yeah. And plus, YouTube, we're about to do, like, a mini intro. So, give me just one moment. This is for editing's sake. I might cut this part out. But, yeah. All right. Here we go. Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel, welcome back to the next episode of The 100. This is Season 7, Episode 16 of the final season, titled The Last War. This is it, guys. This is the series finale. I literally just finished watching the previous episode where we ended off with Maddie, like, just strapped to that chair, lifeless. She is aware of her surroundings. She can hear things, but she was left behind like garbage. I'm rooting for Clark to just kill the fuck out of this Cadigan guy, because Maddie doesn't deserve to go out like that. But it almost got me, guys. I started to feel the tears. The show's never gotten me to that point before, really. I mean, it's gotten me shocked plenty of times when it came to Octavia's character and all that, but it almost got me. We're going to see how this all turns out, because Amori's dying. Maddie's basically dead. I don't know who else is going to kind of like get caught in the crossfire here, or if someone's going to make some sort of sacrifice, or who's going to make it, who's not. This is it, guys. This is the final episode. I cannot wait to see what happens. So enough talking. Let's just hop in, have a good time, discuss it after. So, but before I do want to remind you guys, Patreon for the full-length, uncut, unedited reactions, as well as early access to everything else you see here on the channel, as well as exclusive reactions. So if any of that interests you, hop on over to Patreon. Of course, if you can't support me over there, you can always support me right here on YouTube. All you gotta do is like, comment, share, subscribe to the channel. Now let's stop talking. Hop in, have a good time, discuss it afterwards. All right, guys. Here we go for the last time. Thank you guys for joining me. I just want to say that one more time. Let's do it. Here we go. Okay, yep. This is the last time. I didn't skip anything, right? It literally started like that. Okay. Oh man, I'm hyped. I'm like super excited for this.
Nothing yet. Clear! Come on! One more time, come on. Raven, clear!
So Maury and Maddie aren't gonna make it out of the series. Oh, okay, never mind.
Just save her.
Don't die. Yeah.
Hey!
Once her Thank you.
Safe, you have to go after Maddie. Okay, you have to stop Cadigan.
No pressure. God, Raven looks good. All dirty and sweaty and shit. Now we're talking. This motherfucker right here.
Mother Shepherdina will be with him guarding the door.
Too bad for them.
Yeah! Woo!
Some more killing, that's the answer. Maybe we don't deserve to transcend.
Bro. Damn! Holy shit! Clark is hardcore! Dude, this is awesome.
Cover me.
What are you thinking, Octavia? Ooh, what is this? It looks different. Why? Where the hell are we? Just some random ass bridge in the middle of the cosmos? Ben was here.
What took you so long?
Is she actually here? Or what is this?
I took you fishing here once.
Why only once?
You jumped in.
No, I told you not to. You never listen.
She took after her mother.
You're not Kelly.
We most often take the form of the subject's greatest teacher.
We?
Their greatest failure.
Are you God?
For our purposes, you may consider me your judge.
My judge, so they were right. This is a trial, a test. Not a war.
Correct.
The
last of kind to stand before us.
Damn, get fucked, bro.
Refused. Is the human race now ready to join us?
Yes.
Excellent. Here's how it works. We talk. I ask questions you answer truthfully. If you do not, I will know it. If you fail to earn this evolutionary leap, you will be eliminated. Turn to crystal the way the Bardoans and countless other civilizations before them were.
No! Great!
First question is about love.
Oh my god. Like this guy knows what this is... Everything about this, his teachings was like anti-love. We're fucked. Oh! That takes care of that. Good. God damn.
Pencils down.
That's so dumb, but I love it. The hell is she doing? Sitting on Auntie O's throne.
I hate waiting. Done too much of it.
Trust me, I know. But Octavia and Clark can take care of themselves.
Thank you.
Can friends do this?
I like this, but damn. It would have been better if he never had a thing with Priya. Oh, what shit!
Saving our asses. Again. Thank you.
That's what Ash would do.
Don't write through there.
I mean, I like this, but I'm like, damn.
Insane from treating Omori. Murphy's with them.
What a turnaround.
Cadogan will be mobilizing his army for war. We got 10 people.
Wish I'd had a dead one who will fight. We gotta sanctum first.
What we need is a distraction, not a fight. A way to get a small team past their army to kill Cadogan.
Cadogan's dead, though. They don't know. Oh, man, this is kind of fun because not everybody knows what's happening. Oh, shit. Look what I found. Here you go. What's up, Echo?
We're through the collapse.
Good. Then let's go.
Wait, what about Gaia?
Andra, we can't wait for her.
Slow down. We still don't have a plan that doesn't end with all of us dead.
Actually, I think Jordan was just about to tell us.
He was?
This one would make my father proud. First trick, I will make an army up here.
I'm offline. Weapons not responsive. I've got nothing.
None of us do.
This is not the stone room. If the structure can still work.
Insertion team, go now.
Copy that. Echo, lead the way.
Oh, okay.
Well, we're distracted.
Long enough for us to die. We all will die. When is out of our control. This is a good hop.
Wait, what? Okay.
She's as stable as she's gonna get. It's time. Two. Three.
The ridge is in the rebar, though.
Hey, come on,
I'm already. Would it be better to, like, maybe unscrew it somehow? The unscrewing motion?
Hurry up!
I die. Oh, she's dying. Yeah, she's not gonna. Holy shit! No. Dude, her lips are blue!
You doing?
Oh my god, is she.
I do something, you're a doctor, please!
She just dies like that? Eyes, oh my god. Wow. Don't do anything dumb, Murphy. There's nothing. Did the best you could.
Take out her mind drive. Put her mind in your head. We know from Clark and Josephine how that ends. I'm telling myself. I got this.
If she gets it done, will my brother transcend?
No. Shepherd's Passage. Book of Bardo, chapter 1, verse 6. Death is the end, my friend. Only the living.
But maybe he will be there.
Must have slept through that class.
Well, the Shepherd is, like, proven to not know jack shit, so we're probably gonna see Bellamy again at the end somehow.
Either way. Transcendence or extinction. I would have liked to live a little first.
Wow. Octavia, you had one hell of a life. Did you have to, like, sneak up on us like that? God damn.
We did.
I could have been all bad.
Kill Maddie. Worse than killed her. Clark went in after him to stop the test. Went in.
How do you know you weren't followed?
Hey, you can relax. The disciples have their hands full with Wonku right now.
If Clark can't stop the test to determine whether or not the human race deserves to transcend while what's left of the human race is fighting a war.
That would be bad.
Worse than bad. If we fail, the Transcendent send Gem 9. The spy.
Look, I'm sorry for what I did to you, okay? I wasn't myself.
We'll meet later. Right now we have to stop the war.
Echo, you've been like all over this place this season. Crazy. Are we all just gonna go take the test? Maybe we're there for moral support.
Why am I still here?
You know why.
Yes!
Alexa.
They really got her. They really got her back.
I'm not her, Clark.
I don't give a fuck. You look like her to me. It's awesome.
The test isn't over. No. I'm sorry. We can't stop what's been set in motion.
Oh, man. This is like, I love this fan service right here. Because you know the fans were like, I bet everyone was like squealing and screaming that Lexa came back. This is awesome.
Why? He killed my daughter.
Yeah.
Is Maddie dead? No. But she will be. Because of him.
Are they going to save her? That'd be kind of cheap.
It's not revenge. It's justice.
Like, maybe Clark gives herself up so Maddie lives? That's the one thing I might accept. I might accept that.
Two strangers down. You don't know my pain. You're wrong. During the test, I sense every part of you.
This is the test right now. We're having a conversation. Yeah, this is the test.
And feel me holding Lexa as she dies. Feel me seeing someone else wear my mother's face.
As she dies.
Feel me murder my best friend to save my child, only to have her die anyway.
Yeah.
Feel that. You suffer. And inflict suffering on others. Pain begets pain, that's not justice, Clark.
Hurt people hurt people. That's what they say, right?
You're all one people. That much Cadogan had right. He created a world without love to get to you. He killed my child. To get to you. Have you ever considered that you're the problem? How dare you judge me?
So what is this deity?
Have I pulled the lever to commit genocide? Yes, I have.
I'll do it again.
But what's your excuse? You play games.
Oh shit.
And call yourselves higher beings. You are no better than the murderers I've killed. And you are no better than me!
God damn!
I am sorry for all you have lost. But if you are humanity, then I am afraid humanity is not worthy of taking the next step.
Oh shit!
It has been decided.
What has been decided?
You can't place Theodore.
Holy shit! Like that? Whoa, wait a minute. What's going on? This is gonna be like their afterlife. They all died. Yep, this is it. She's not gonna have the claw thing or anything. I don't know. Let's see. Okay, so she does have the claw thing. Oh shit.
I remember that. Place we first met.
Alright. Remember Jaha, everybody? We're dead.
Josephine called it the mind space.
No. Oh.
Die.
You did. Not acceptable.
Oh, man.
You put my mind drive in your head. Two minds, one body. You
oh, no.
I would take a few more hours to live forever without.
No.
Not Murphy, too.
More.
Wake up. Just wake up. Wake up. Wake up! Jackson! Wake him up! Don't let him do this! John! Don't let go of me!
Hey, it's okay with me!
Is he okay with me?
It's okay.
What's that? What?
The last time I asked you to dance, you stabbed me with a butcher knife.
The red sun toxin.
Relationships.
Yeah.
Oh, this is it. Oh, God. Fuck.
Clark? Oh, that can't be good. What have I done? Clark, wait. Did you take the test?
Yeah, we failed.
What happened?
We failed. Fuck.
I failed.
Yeah, shit. We're all dead now.
They should have picked you first.
So that's it?
We're dead.
We don't transcend it. We're wiped. It's over?
Yeah. Okay, here so?
I don't know. I need to be with Maddie. There's not much time.
Mark, wait!
Raven, are you going to sacrifice yourself or something? I feel like someone's going to do that.
Touching the pulsar, what could go wrong?
Ah, Raven. That's so Raven. Are we going to see Finn or something?
No way.
Oh. Spacewalking?
About 42 billion light years away.
Oh, Abby. I guess that makes sense to have Abby. It's kind of like her surrogate mother.
But we were just trying to survive.
But at least let us live. Keep trying to do better. We will. We have.
You say you have. Yet even now you are poised and on the brink of self-extermination.
War is happening. Oh, okay. They're still at a standstill.
You say you're trying to do better. But all I see are two tribes of frightened creatures willing to kill the other to save themselves.
This proves nothing.
They will fight, Raven, like they always
I'm
do.
Honestly surprised no one's fired the first shot yet. Ah, oh, shit.
The games begin.
This motherfucker. I guess he had to fuck some shit up. Well, there we go. How do you know this?
Nonsense.
Oh, shit.
History is written by the victors. Let's try this again.
Yeah, saw that coming.
Return fire!
Yeah, now we're gonna have a bunch of senseless death right now. Don't just run out there, Octavia! What are you doing? God damn it! She better not die this way!
Michael, you're hit! What the hell are you doing?
I lost Bellamy. I will not lose his sister.
Don't you see? Despite the beauty that humans are capable of, you can't break free from the cycle of violence.
Hi, baby. I'm here.
This is who you are. That's why you failed the test.
I'm so sorry I failed you. I failed everyone.
It's time for us to go, Raven. The end of the human race is here.
Jordan, oh! Don't let them die. The dead don't transcend.
To be honest, I'd save Echo over the other guy. There was never really enough for me to really buy him as, like, I don't know, love interest for Octavia. I just don't buy it.
Hold the tip player! Hold the tip player! Ingrid is not in command here. I am! And I say, do strain!
Everyone just, like, turned their guns on him and just, like, blow him away.
Do strain! Do strain!
Well, this isn't good. Can someone kill this motherfucker, man? There we go! Wow.
What the hell are we doing here? You swore an oath to fight for all mankind. Well, look around you. We are mankind. We are one group. If we keep killing each other, there won't be anyone left to save. Our fight is over, Indra.
Okay.
I hope you know what we're doing. We're unarmed. I know you're afraid to walk away from everything you spent your lives training for. I am too.
It'd be some shit if they just gunned him down.
I've been to war, and let me tell you,
I'm glad it's Octavia.
The only way to win is not to fight.
My speech.
You heard that?
This is not any here.
Dude.
No, no.
Yeah. If Echo dies like this, I'm not a fan of that. I don't even like that she ran out after Octavia. Who ran out after Levin? Like, what?
For all mankind.
I wish we knew some of the people, some of the Bardoans, like these guys. Because I'd be like, oh wow, look at that huge turnaround. But it's just like a bunch of nameless, faceless people.
Please.
What are you doing?
I said.
She's transcending. Oh, they're all transcending. So they all lost, right? Why isn't Octavia transcending? Okay.
Jax. We're going.
They still have time for some mind space sex. Right on, man. Oh, they're still together. Oh, that was cute. What's happening?
I know you don't want to leave me.
Oh, she's fighting it.
But you have to go now. Let go, Maddie. Just let go.
Oh, man.
I'll be okay. I love you forever, Maddie.
If you tear yourself into again.
Is anyone here? Murphy!
I like how she calls for Murphy first. There was always something there. Hey! How the hell is the dog still around? And why is Clark still here? Oh, they're back on Earth, huh?
Today, water and shelter. Tomorrow, food. Okay?
Picasso, come!
Oh, man. What are they gonna find?
Picasso! Please come back! I don't want to be alone! I don't want to be alone.
You're not.
Maddie? Oh, Alexa.
What do you want to explain?
Yeah, what's going on? Is this her punishment?
I bear it so they don't have to. Again, such a curious species. I'm glad to have been wrong about you. Does that mean you're here to take me with you? No. You can never join us, Clark.
What?
You are the only test subject from any species anywhere in the universe who committed murder during the test.
Okay.
I'd do it again.
So this is her consequence for... What the fuck? I mean, that's Clara. She can't help herself but kill someone, but...
She'll never die. She knew that living here without anyone her own age to love... It's something you wouldn't have wanted for her. Transcendence is a choice. You can choose to come back. Of course.
Hmm?
Though until now, no one ever had.
I guess. Okay. So that's where Picasso went? But obviously not everybody, right?
There won't be offspring. And they won't join us when they die. None of them seem to care.
Hey!
There she is.
A curious species indeed.
Okay. I'm a little conflicted about this ending, not gonna lie. Alright guys, so that was the final episode of The 100. That was season 7, episode 16 of the final season, the series finale titled The Last War. I'm not gonna lie. I mean, there's a lot of good in this episode, but there's some stuff in there that I was kind of like really? Like scratching my head about. And I'm not sure what it was, to be honest, but I feel like that ending felt a little cheap. And I don't know why. I don't know. And I'm about to go back and see, because when she walked up onto them, like kind of just, you know, hanging out on the beach or whatever, I don't remember seeing Maddie there. I'm going to have to go back and watch it right now, to be honest. All right, so they decided to come back. Transcendence is a choice, blah, blah, blah. Okay. She goes around. She sees, okay, I don't see Maddie. Where is Maddie at? So, there won't be offspring and they won't join us when they die. Huh. So this is what? They just came back almost like to just, damn, I don't know. This is just such an it's interesting. But there's like some choices here. Like when I saw what was in the background, I saw Levin and Octavia. I don't buy it. I don't know why. I don't buy their romance or love story or anything like that. I get, you know, that I don't know, that you want to like have these people end on, you know, positive notes. Everyone has like their own significant other. But it just, I don't know. It just feels, it feels weird. I don't know. I don't feel satisfied about this. Cause I'm looking around. I see what Murphy, Amori, there's Octavia, Clark. There's, was that Levitt, Raven, Jackson. I think that's Hope. That's a Jordan, Indra, Miller. Didn't I see Nyla? Where's Nyla? Did I miss Nyla? Oh, there she wasn't. Nyla and Gaia are back there. Yeah, okay. So I like that what we got, you know, with Lexa. Those scenes were really good. I love the scene where Murphy and Amori were kind of like saying goodbye, or at least Murphy was. And even the scene in their mind space was a really solid conclusion to their story. But I don't know. There's just something about the Last War itself. It just felt a little, it felt weird. It felt a little goofy. I don't want to make it seem like I'm just ragging on it a little bit, but it just didn't feel that satisfying to me, to be honest. I feel like everything leading up to it, like from the last episode, like leading into this, I felt like this, like everything was like set up for the perfect home run, but it didn't feel like a home run to me. Like with Shade Hata, he was just like, trying to rile everybody, like, no, 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 don't listen to Indra. Kill each other. Come on, chop, chop. But then Indra just walks up and blasts him, like, obliterates him, and that's just it. They just move on. Now, I get the idea that Shade Hate is not exactly the big bad of the season, and not necessarily, I don't know, the focus of the final couple episodes or the final bit of the story, but I felt like that was just too easy. Like they, like the writers almost just like just threw that into the script. Like, oh my god, what are we gonna do with Shade Hater? I don't know. Indra blows him up. What the fuck? I thought the whole thing was gonna be, oh, Shade Hater, you want to rule this whole kingdom, rule this whole planet by yourself. There's gonna be no way for you to get to, no way for you to leave, no way, no how for people to come to you. You will be stuck on this planet forever throughout the rest of time just by yourself in your own prison. Not only are you locked inside that guy's body that's not even your own, but now you're locked onto this planet. That's what I thought was going to happen. I felt like that was going to be a poetic end to Shade Hata, I guess, if they didn't just obliterate him like that comically. I just feel like they could have done a little bit more with Shade Hata, not going to lie. I felt like he was like such a big deal, at least he was a big deal until he wasn't. You know what I mean? It's like the episodes were like taking turns on who was really the big bad. Because Shade Hata was like killing people left and right looking for Maddie. But then Cadogan took over. It's like, I'll do you one better. I'm actually going to kill Maddie. So I'm just like, what the fuck? So they kind of like took turns like being the big bad. And I don't know. I just felt like Shade Hata got out. It was just kind of like a lame ending for him, I guess. And don't get me started on the whole Echo thing. Like, I get her reasoning, because she already lost Velmi and she doesn't want to lose Octavia either, but there just wasn't enough for me to care about the Octavia and Levitt thing for her to run out there after he willingly put himself in the crossfire. Like, we all knew what was going to happen. When Levitt got shot, I just thought he was going to be turned into fucking Swiss cheese, but he only took one shot, which is lucky, to say the least. But when Octavia ran out there, I'm just like, oh, hell no. Then Echo runs out there, and I'm just like, oh, hell no. Then Echo gets hit? Come on, man. Not only that, then they, like, cut to a scene, and Levitt and Echo are side by side, like, dying. And I'm just like, really? Really? Echo, like, has this big badass arc this whole entire season where she just kind of goes crazy looking for Bellamy, only to wind up like that, suffering on the ground next to some scrub. That thing's just because he slid into Octavia's DMs that he's part of the main cast now. Like, come on, man. I wasn't a fan of that. Hope and Jordan almost had a moment. I mean, they did have a moment, but they almost had a better moment until, you know, stuff happens. There was just a lot of things that were good, but then there were like some story choices that they just didn't click with me. And I'm not sure if I'm supposed to feel that way, or how do you guys feel about the finale in general? Like, I know that there's some mixed feelings and reactions to the season, because I guess people were upset at the lack of Bellamy. Like, even here, there was no Bellamy in the last episode. I just thought about that. Like, I thought we're gonna, like, and here's another thing I was like thinking about in my mind. It's like, okay, they're all gonna die. They failed. They're all going to be in some sort of heaven or whatever, the city of light of some sort. And I feel like that's where they're going to be able to see everybody, because they can, like, conjure up images or whatever. Like, they're just going to be, like, just data in the clouds, you know what I mean, more or less. And I just thought that they're going to be able to see the past, the present, the future, like, just all, like, forms of like, all avenues of the show took throughout the beginning until now. That would be, like, the excuse to see everybody, like, cameo-wise, like, for, like, pure fan service. Like, I just thought we were going to get some sort of, like, conclusion to the Bellamy and Clark story. Because if that's really it, that was really it for Bellamy. He legit died because Clark shot him. And that was it. I'm flabbergasted that was the direction they took with this character. I'm shocked that they didn't bring him back to have some sort of moment with Clark. Like, even when she was taking the test, I understand why the deity, the god, whatever, took the form of Lexa. That makes sense, but I'm just like, it would have also made sense if it was Bellamy too. You know what I mean? So, I don't know. That's another thing that just kind of, like, takes off some points for me, I guess, from the finale. It's like, you have this whole setup. Like, I don't know. I just feel like, to me personally, this finale kind of disappointed me. But it delivered some really good, like, acting moments. Like, I legit got emotional for these scenes. Like, I know, like, throughout the beginning run of Amori's character, I know I wasn't, like, the biggest fan of her. I always felt like she was always, like, causing trouble and whatever. But she was a ride or die for John. And they were a ride or die for each other. And that, their story and their relationship, like, that kind of transcended, to kind of steal a word from the show, kind of transcended who they were as people. Because they were kind of, like, shitty people. They were scummy. They're cockroaches. They do what they do to survive. But the fact that they have this love, and that would have been awesome if Murphy or Amori took the test too. Because Murphy changed so much. It's like, he may be selfish, like a selfish prick, but like his love for Amori, I mean, it's like undeniable. I felt like if anything, if we had to give someone, like, someone unlikely to take the test, it could have been Murphy and we would have passed. You know what I mean? But the entire test thing in general was just kind of like, whatever. Clark took it. She failed. And the ending was kind of like, eh. Because I felt like Clark was just going to suffer, just be on this planet by herself. That was just going to be it. But then the deity says that God, I don't know what really to call her, Lexa, quote unquote, basically told her that, you know, there's a choice to untranscend. Am I getting this right? They transcended to be at peace or whatever, right? But they decided to come back to join Clark because they don't want Clark to be alone. But because of that, they no longer have the option to transcend back. So now they're stuck here, but Clark gets the opportunity to transcend later? Is that what I got from that conversation? Because the person said they won't join us later. You know what I'm saying? So I'm assuming Clark just has to, like, whatever, serve her time here. And then all of a sudden, and then at some point, some way, somehow, she'll have the ability to transcend. But then what's the point of that if everyone else is stuck here? So I don't know. That was just kind of like a weird conversation to me. Trying to think what else happened here. It was cool seeing Abby back. I mean, I don't know. I would have, like, tried to figure out some way to get, like, more cameos. Like, maybe, like, get a Kane back in here. Allie, maybe. I don't know. Like, it felt like this finale could have had a bit more fan service. Instead of doing this weird last war, last stand. Everyone kind of, like, I don't know. It felt weird. Or at least I felt like this final episode could have been a little bit longer. Just kind of like help flesh out the story a little bit. Maybe like write things a little bit differently. But for the most part, it was a solid episode. It's just for me personally, it kind of missed a few marks, at least for me personally. And I personally would have just loved to see Maddie at the end here. But I guess they did kind of explain now that I remember. They were saying that Maddie decided she wasn't going to come down here because she knew, like, it wouldn't have been, it would not be, she says something like, it wouldn't be cool for her to be down here with, like, no one else her age, and she'll basically, like, have no life or something like that. So I guess that kind of makes sense, but I'm just like, she would be here with her friends, though. Right? So what is she doing now? Just hanging out in the glowy lights in the sky? Like, what? I don't know. I kind of wish that there's more. I kind of wish there was a season 8, episode 1, or some sort of follow-up, or maybe 10 years later, what happens? You know, I don't know. I feel like this is it's a solid conclusion to this story, but I definitely want to know what happens next. And I don't know. It feels like this is not. It feels like it's over, but it's not. You know what I mean? I don't know. I don't know if that makes any sense at all. But what else is going on? I'm kind of just gonna strip through this, make sure I got everything. Cadogan dying immediately was a shock. Didn't see that. Didn't see that coming. I don't know. Just like kind of going through this. And I thought, if anything, maybe Echo was going to have like a better death than that. Because she just died trying to protect Octavia. I thought, if anything, she was going to have like a warrior's death. You know what I mean? Like some sort of sacrifice. Like maybe jump on a grenade type of thing. I don't know. Like I felt like that this episode lacked certain story beats that could have made it like really like make it stand out that much more. But for what we got, I don't know, I'd probably give it like a 7.5 maybe for a finale for an episode 2. But yeah, it was a solid episode. For the series overall, though, I feel like we're gonna have to do another video just to kind of like talk about it, maybe talk about ideas for if I were to kind of like fantasy book the show, like if I were in charge of the reboot, how would I do this? How would I come across it? Or how would I approach it? Probably be some fun ideas. I don't know if maybe you guys thought about what season 8 would be like, or a reboot or a remake of some sort or whatever. Like maybe you guys have some fan theories on what happens like down the line with Clark or Maddie and all that stuff. But I'm very interested to see what you guys have to say about this finale, because I'm not going to lie, I was a little... It's a mixed bag for me. It's a mixed bag. It got me emotional in some parts. There were some really cool moments. There was also some moments that just left me scratching my head, wishing they kind of like went in a different direction. But for what it was a solid episode to wrap up a solid series. I really enjoyed the series a lot. I know I kind of gave it a hard time from the beginning, like seasons 1 and 2. Yeah, no, I didn't really like really get into it, like I think like late season 3, season 4. But looking back on it, I really enjoyed seeing like how we started out from "we're back, bitches" to where we are now. It just feels like a very mature, it grew up, it matured. We kind of like watched these characters, watched them grow. And it just feels like in some ways it's a satisfying conclusion, but in some ways I would have done some things differently. But let's not beat a dead horse here. It was a good, solid series. I'm glad I watched it. I'm glad you guys stuck around with me from the beginning. If you guys did, let me know in the comments down below. And just let me know what you guys felt about the series in general. What did you feel about the final season? Did you dislike it because of the lack of Bellamy? Were you disappointed there was no Bellamy in the final episode? I mean, let me know. I'm really interested to kind of like dive deep into the comments and just see where you guys, where your head's at, because I have a ton of things to say. And like I said, I might to come up with another video kind of like discussing the show and all this stuff, like just everything in general, because I feel like there's so much to talk about, and now that it's over I don't have enough and then a big enough platform to really kind of just keep talking. So I feel like if anything, I'll probably do another follow-up video about the whole series, maybe rank characters or talk about characters, or maybe like fantasy book, like I said, a reboot. What would I do with certain characters, or you know what I mean? I don't know. Let me know what you guys want. If there's bloopers or cast interviews or anything like that you guys want me to check out or want me to do reactions to, let me know in the comments down below. Send me links, all that good stuff. But I think that's pretty much it. It was a solid series. And I was entertained. I just wish there was a little bit more, but it was neither here nor there, and I think I'm just getting it there. All right, guys, if you guys enjoyed my review, enjoyed my reaction, guys want to see this episode with me in its entirety, the option is available to you right now over on Patreon. Links are in the description down below or pinned in the top comment. If you can't support me on Patreon, go support me right here on YouTube. All you got to do is like, comment, share, subscribe to the channel. Now I'm going to get out of here, and I'll catch you guys next time in the next series, whatever it may be. But until then, I do want to say to you guys once more, happy holidays, and thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You guys make this possible. Make this like a fun, enjoyable hobby to do, just to kind of just watch shows with you guys, talk with you guys, theorize with you guys. It's fun. It's been enjoyable. Thank you once again, and adios.
And if you liked what you saw, tell your friends, tell your family, tweet about it. And if you didn't like it, shut the fuck up.